And we gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
As we gather here today as God's family, with confidence we call upon our Heavenly Father, knowing of his mercy and of his compassion. Forgive us of our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection. For he lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
This passage refers to the Ark of God, which was a wooden chest overlaid by gold, where the stones of the tablets of the Ten Commandments were kept. King David, rich and comfortable in his own palace, felt the ark deserved to be housed in similar splendor. God will tell David that a physical building is not as important as the house, that is, the dynasty of David. And Christians have seen this prophecy fulfilled in Christ, who was born of the house of David.
A reading from the second book of Samuel. When King David was settled in his palace, and the Lord had given him rest from his enemies on every side, he said to Nathan the prophet, "Here I am living in a house of cedar, while the ark of God dwells in a tent." Nathan answered the king, "Go do whatever you have in mind, for the Lord is with you." But that night the Lord spoke to Nathan and said, "Go tell my servant David, thus says the Lord, should you build me a house to dwell in? It was I who took you from the pasture and from the care of the flock to be commander of my people Israel. I have been with you wherever you went, and I have destroyed all your enemies before you. And I will make you famous like the great ones of the earth. I will fix a place for my people Israel. I will plant them so that they may dwell in their place without further disturbance. Neither shall the wicked continue to afflict them as they did of old, since the time I first appointed judges over my people Israel. I will give you rest from all your enemies. The Lord also reveals to you that he will establish a house for you. And when your time comes and you rest with your ancestors, I will raise up your heir after you, sprung from your loins, and I will make his kingdom firm. I will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me. Your house and your kingdom shall endure forever before me. Your throne shall stand firm forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Today's passage concludes Paul's long letter to the Romans. It is one sentence long and is very much like a toast offered to God. In effect, Paul is saying that it all comes down to this. We should give thanks to God that salvation is available to all people through faith in Jesus Christ.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, to him who can strengthen you according to my gospel and the proclamation of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery kept secret for long ages, but now manifested through the prophetic writings and according to the command of the eternal God, made known to all nations to bring about the obedience of faith to the only wise God, through Jesus Christ, be glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. In coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who once was called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." And then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Even a heavenly messenger tells you, "Do not be afraid." These are still frightening events. Because in Mary's world and in our world, virgins do not become pregnant. Kings are not born to peasants. And angels bringing news of our salvation don't usually make house calls. And yet we're told that this is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. Now it's tempting to look back on that moment when the Word became flesh and see it as an amazing story that happened to Mary, a plaster statue with palms never sweating, whose knees never buckled, whose heart never pounded with terror or with joy. Yet this story cannot be controlled or contained neatly in the past. For like Mary, we are invited to help give birth to Jesus Christ in our world. By working for justice, even when it's just easier to walk away. By speaking the truth, even when it's more safer to remain silent. It's a challenge guaranteed to make our hearts pound and our palms sweat.
We look at Mary and see in her a wonderful role model for our own lives. We can only imagine what went through her mind on that extraordinary day, or the following days of her pregnancy, and all that came afterwards. All we know is that she placed herself at God's service, and that God found her to be a worthy vessel to carry his only begotten Son. As we heard in our first reading, the mighty King David was not permitted to provide a home for the Lord, but the Virgin Mary was chosen instead. She was not to build the temple for God, but to be the temple of God. And we need to see that God calls us to do more than build a house for his presence. He calls us to be the house of his presence. God calls us to radiate his love, to radiate his love to a world that looks for a Savior, that longs for a Savior. Gabriel spoke to Mary and waited for her response. God speaks to each and every one of us throughout our lives, and our God is waiting for our response.
And together now let us stand as we make our profession of our faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom I have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son are adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sin, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And filled with that Advent joy, we have the courage to make known our needs and our desires to our God.
For the Church, that our hearts may be an authentic dwelling place for God, and thus enable us to bring God's presence to all whom we encounter, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For peace and justice, that the advent of the Prince of Peace may enlighten minds and hearts to resolve disputes with words and open new pathways of justice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the gift of wisdom, that like Mary, we may ponder God's invitations to us and give our full yes to all that God asks of us, so that we may bring forth God's saving presence in our world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For a listening heart, that our hearts may be stilled and quieted, so that we may hear the word of God as it comes to us in word, event, and experience each day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For an end to the COVID pandemic, that God will heal the sick, strengthen the caregivers, and guide the distribution and administration of the vaccines, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who are isolated or alone, particularly those who are homebound or away with family and friends, that Christ may fill their emptiness and open our hearts to reach out to them and reunite them with loved ones in the new year, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the spirit of healing, particularly for those inscribed in our Book of the Sick, that God will strengthen their minds and bodies and restore them to wholeness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who have died this week, that God will welcome them into the eternal banquet, to live in God's presence forever. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the prayers we now offer for all parishioners, including Audrey Chavez and J.R. Gutierrez, and for the repose of the souls of Reverend Bernard Bush, Samantha Faye Arenas, Richard Ives, Frank Petroni, and Rita Sanchez. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Good and gracious God, we make known to our needs and our desires, those we speak aloud and those we speak in the silence of our hearts. We ask that you grant them, for we ask them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Normally we would take up our offertory at this time. As we know, we're not able to do so. But I would encourage you to take the moment today, or in the coming days, to go ahead and make your donation. Either do it online, you can do it on the screen that you're looking at right now, to scroll down and follow the link there. Or you can go to our parish website, or the diocesan website. You can also put it in the mail, or drop it off at the parish office. We thank you in advance for your generosity and continue to remind you how thankful we are for your generosity as well. Sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the Holy Spirit, O Lord, sanctify these gifts laid upon your altar, just as he filled with his power the womb of the Blessed Virgin Mary, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right and just,
our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when at last he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in our praise. And so with the angels and the archangels, with the thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we now acclaim.
Amen.
You are indeed holy, Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." And let us proclaim the mystery of our faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that by partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Oscar, our bishop, and all the clergy and religious, remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all. We pray that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. And together now, let us pray for the coming of God's kingdom as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, for you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of that peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And let us pray. Having received this pledge of eternal redemption, we pray, Almighty God, that as the feast day of our salvation draws ever near, so we may press forward all the more eagerly to the worthy celebration of the mystery of your Son's Nativity. For he lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
And I remind you once again that we are having Masses in our daily Mass in our courtyard, Monday through Friday, 8:30 in the morning, and Saturday morning at 8 o'clock in the morning. We have a 4 o'clock Saturday Vigil Mass in the courtyard, and on Sunday morning at 9 o'clock and 10:30, we have a Mass in the courtyard as well. You do need to make reservations for those Masses. It's on our parish website. Just follow the link to make those reservations. Our Christmas schedule is for Thursday, December 24th, Christmas Eve. We have a 12 o'clock noon Mass. We have a 2 o'clock in the afternoon and a 4 o'clock in the afternoon Mass as well. And on Christmas Day, we have a 9 o'clock, 10:30, and a 12:15 in the afternoon. And again, you need to make reservations for those Masses as well. And you can do that on the parish website as well. Thank you in advance, and I hope that you have a great day. Remember to keep your distance, wash your hands, wear your mask, and we'll get through all this together. Have a great day. And may the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Master today has come to its end. May we go in peace to love and to serve our Lord.
Thanks be to God.